All right, welcome back everybody. Got a fun one for you today. Got a new toy for you to play with in ZBrush 2021. Previous videos, we've gone over how to do torn cloth inside ZBrush 2021. And I decided to make a little plugin for you to speed up the process. So I figured I would take this project that I was working on. I'm not quite finished yet, but I've got a good point here to showcase the plugin in action. And before we do that, I want to do a quick install instructions. So if you downloaded it, this is what comes with it. Not a whole lot of files associated with this here. You'll have a folder with all the macros in there, as well as some presets for fiber mesh, and then a couple alphas that you can use to mask out your tears on your cloth. So, and then also a Keyshot 9 cloak material, which I really think turns out really good, and I'll show you at the end of this here. So basically, this is what you got. And then there's also this ZTL file, which is for your micro poly. And let me show you how to install it. So this torn cloth here is actually going to go into your load up ZBrush 2021 under Pixelogic there, and find your startup directory, your Z startup. Go under macros and then copy it to right here. I already have it in here. And then go back up to the main directory and find micro poly. Open that up and then take the TC weave one and plug it in there. So if you ever wonder where all those ZTL files are for the micro polys, this is where they exist. So you can go in here, open them up, modify them to your heart's content. We can go over that in another video. But for today, we now have our torn cloth plugin, and I'm going to show you how it works. So basically, we're just going to use this cloak here that I already, you know, folded and moved around and whatnot and got it to where I kind of like it. So what we want to do is go ahead and I'm going to apply the dynamic subdivision. And then I'm probably going to give it another divide, because you want it to be at least a million points. So that's going to help with the masking process. And if you hold down your control, we're going to change your mask pin to drag rec. Open up your alpha, import, and let me find, there we go. I'm just going to grab one of these. We'll do tear 2, and that's in that torn cloth folder that you put into your macros, and we're going to use that to mask out the parts that we want torn up. Okay, so go ahead and click drag. What you want to do, control Z, hold down your control, change your focal shift, -100. There we go. So now it's a nice pretty mask. You'll have to fight with it a little bit here. So we're going to do control, backface mask, and see if that helps us out. Yeah, there we go. It won't draw underneath so much. Or you can always hand draw this stuff on here. It's not a big deal. Just wherever you want some tears on the cloth. And I figured these little alphas would help you out here. I'm just using one for now. And I'm just going to go around real quick with a couple of these. And this is why we needed the resolution, so they would look a lot better when we put them out. All right. Put one more here by the elbow. All right. It's just wherever you want. You don't have to use the alphas if you don't want. You could turn the alpha off. You could just do freehand. Okay, so if you wanted, let's take the straw size down. We can just draw a little one right here. Back face masking's giving me issues. So you can do whatever you want. You can even go through it, erase some of it, whatever. So we're just gonna stick with this. And we're gonna go ahead and run a macro. So you can open up your macro up here. And if you scroll down, if you have everything, let me close up some of these here. All right. And here's the new torn cloth here. I've got a couple presets here for the, this one, the 25K to 55K will do everything for you. Or I've got one that just does the edge fibers or the fuzz on the outside. So, and basically what it's doing is it's going to retopologize everything. It's going to delete those masked areas, retopologize, and then add everything to it. So let's go ahead. We'll go gusto here, and we'll do the 55K, and we'll let it go through here, and we'll watch it work. Like I said, it's gonna delete your mask stuff there. It's gonna do a little polish on it. It's gonna run like a fix mesh on there, and then it's gonna Z remesh to about 55,000 polygons. It's probably gonna be a little bit less, but that's gonna be fine, because once we do the micro poly, it's gonna raise our poly count enormously. But when this plugin happens, it keeps it in just a dynamic mode, so you can fiddle with it or whatever before you commit to, you know, 16 million polygons on the cloth itself. So here we are, still waiting for Z remesh to do its process here. It's got a lot of calculations it's got to do. And there we go. It'll run another integrity check. A little chaos there. No. No. So just whenever you see mesh integrity, just click on the screen. I can't figure out how to get rid of those dialogues. So, and there we go. It's done everything for us there. So it's not a one button fix all type thing. You still got to go in here and manipulate things here. I'm going to solo this. And I am going to do maybe fix that a little bit there, smooth it out. Z remesh had some major issues there. All right. So basically what we have here, we've got our original cloth cut up nice and neat. And if you turn dynamic off, you can see what it really is. It's a lower poly mesh, about 49,000 points. So kind of roughly where we wanted it. And then it created the fibers, the cloth fuzz, and then it created the edge fibers. So now let's turn dynamic back on. And it'll throw that micro poly back on there for you. And let's go in here and fix our edge in here. Okay, so it's not perfect right out the gate, so you got to do a little work. So I'm not going to make it too easy for you. So go into your groom brushes, so BG, and we're going to do lengthen. We're going to take an alpha 8, so it's not grabbing everything. And we can turn the intensity down a little bit. Now if you hold shift and keep it held, go to your brushes and change it to groom spin knot. And then keep on holding it, change your alpha to 8 or 7, whatever you want. Change your intensity down a little bit. So now we got our dual function brush here that's all about grooming our fibers. So that'll make it real quick and easy. So our main brush is is for lengthening, and then we can knock it back a bit. With our spin knot. I found these two to be the most effective there. Just be sure you change your camera angle, because these are camera based. So if it looks good one way, you better double check it, because it might look hinky another way. And then you just go in and smooth it out, or not necessarily smooth it out, just use your spin knot or whatever it's called. Yeah, spin knot. And you just go through here and do this all over here. So I am going to pause this real quick. I'm going to go through it and then I'll get back with you. Hold on. Alright, I'm back. Spent about 10 minutes playing with that with the two different brushes there, the groom lengthen and the groom spin knot. And this is what I kind of came up with here. Just kind of went around, pulled things around, then used my smooth, or in this case, the spin knot, and kind of knock things back a bit. If things are still getting unruly and clumping up like that, you can do shift, hold that down, go to smooth cloth, turn that intensity way down, and we'll throw that alpha on there to give a little randomness, and then you can just come over there and just tap it a little bit, and it'll suck that those fibers right back in. It'll just shrink it down to the root, which is pretty cool. So like I said, if it gets a little unruly, just do the smooth cloth on there. May raise that up a little bit. That'll shrink it back down, get rid of some of those clumps a bit, and you're good to go with your fibers. So now let's take a look at the cloak itself, because you can add some wear to that as well. So let's go to our cloak, and if you go under geometry, go to dynamic, and you click apply, and here's the micro poly that's on here, and we're gonna fit and weld. We can throw in a line on there, really won't do much to it. Click apply and watch our point count jump up. See, now we're up to 14 million points on that bad boy. So this is a 100% 3D editable model now. So we could do some things to this here. So let's zoom in here so you can kind of get a sense of what's going on. I'm going to turn the polyfill on, and now you can see all the little threads that I have in here. I made sure that each thread had its own poly group, so that can come in handy if you want to mask out your poly groups. So let's take off, let's just go to standard, actually go to inflate, alpha 8 again, let's go ahead, change it to a regular smooth with alpha 8. Want to lower down the intensity here. Okay, so you can, if you wanted, you can hit the smooth and you can smooth out some of those threads quickly and easily. Or you can do the opposite. Whoops, that's too much. On your inflate, just keep it around 2. So now you can go in here, you do a little smoothing, you can do a little inflating back up. We've got the brush alpha in there to help randomize things a little bit. But you can take it one step further, like I said. You can go to, I gotta find it, it's under brush, go to auto masking, and you can mask by polygroup. And like I said, you got each one of those little threads in there has its own polygroup. So you could just, so say like I want to just inflate a particular thread, and you can see just one particular thread is inflating. And same thing on the smooth. You just smooth out one set of threads, or you can even do move, and we could just totally destroy a particular thread. The name of the game is to make it as random as possible here. So now you can see we can get a bunch of different, we can get a bunch of torn look to everything. Go back to inflate. We can turn off mask by polygroups. I'm just going to do just do a quick smooth over everything. I'm not going to go crazy here. Just for the sake of demonstration here. Oh, I still got mask by polygroups on. I thought I turned it off. But you can see how quickly, with the little plug-in there, you can get a real convincing-looking cloth. So let's take it into KeyShot, and we can play with... We can try to get a nice little render out of this guy. All right, here we are in KeyShot here. Sent everything over, about 50 million triangles. That's quite a bit. I'm going to zoom in here, get a look at that head. And we'll slap some materials on here. We'll just do a matte gray for everything else. And then if you wanted, you can load up that material that I sent. Let me see how easily this works. I've never tried it, so we'll find out. So it's a Key S9 gray cloak. Open it, done. And where did I put it? Right here. Okay, it's whatever folder you're in at the time. And then drop it onto the cloth, and then we'll drop it onto the edge. And then it's always hard to get those little fibers there. And boop. They're kind of hard to see. If you zoom in real close, you'll be able to see them. Maybe. Where'd they go? Huh. Oh, they're there. Just here, there, and everywhere. Let that resolve a little bit. We'll check it out and see how it looks. All right, we got it rendered here for a little bit here. And as you can see, we've got a pretty convincing torn cloth going on here. And it really did not take us long at all to make it. And it's quite versatile. So really, it's going to be great for any... renders or anything you got going on. As for doing for like games and stuff like that, yeah, I don't think this is going to work that well for that. There's definitely going to, you're going to have to find some alternatives to this, but it's really good for your illustrations and concepts and stuff like that. So, but that's about it in a nutshell, guys. I hope you have fun with this. Definitely shoot me some samples of what you've been doing with it. And I hope you enjoy it. And we're going to catch you in the next video. You guys have a great day.